Hey guys, I'm here with a new nail tutorial. This one is a how-to for shaping your nails. I guess kind of a manicure tutorial. This was a requested video by CristalLoverable. She had commented on one of my videos, my nail design videos, and she was asking how I shape my nails. So right now my nails aren't even shaped. I kind of tend to just let them grow, and then I just file them as I need to. A couple of the tools that you're going to need are a nail clipper, a nail file. I have a couple here just to show you. They come in various shapes and sizes and different grits, and depending on how strong or weak your nails are, you're going to need a different kind of nail file. What I also use is a cuticle pusher and a trimmer as well. I also suggest that you have some kind of cuticle cream. A really good one is Burt's Bees. Unfortunately, I actually have two of those, but I can't find either one of them, of course, for this tutorial. So it looks like one of these. This is just the hand saw, but it comes in the same kind of tin. Instead of using a cuticle cream, I'm going to be using my Burt's Bees beeswax hand cream. So you're going to want to dab this onto your cuticles, massage it in, allow it to really absorb into your cuticles so that they will be more inclined to being pushed with your cuticle pusher. I like to lay down a piece of paper. What I'd like to do is actually wipe off most of that cream, any residue that's left over. It leaves kind of like that waxiness to your fingers, and it's a little bit greasy. Push your cuticles back. Some people don't actually like to cut their cuticles. I think it's more of a preference thing, but I do, where they tend to be sticking out a little bit. What this is a cuticle, a clipper, but it doesn't have that kind of scissor function. It has a little blade right in between. I don't know how well this is picking up on camera, but right in between here is a little kind of razor. And so you lay it flat on the cuticle and you just push it along, and it scrapes up anything you don't want. The next thing that I'm going to be doing is clipping my nails. I like to look at both hands and see where the shortest nail is, because I want to match that shortest nail. I'm going to say that my shortest nail actually is my thumbnail, because that one broke a while back ago. And trim my nails according to that shortest nail. The way that I do it is I like to do it in two steps. I like to cut, clip from one side, and then I continue and I clip on the other side. I think maybe I'll switch my paper just so you can see a little bit better. Okay, so the key to getting this shape, and that's what CristalLoverable was really looking for, is really starting it off with the cut. If you're going for a squared shape, you're going to try to cut it straight across. If you're going for more of a rounded shape, you're going to cut more along the side, hit the middle, and then cut once more on the other side. So it has that rounded shape already forming. This, I'm just trying to go straight across, so it's more of a squared shape. And that really helps out, so you have to do a lot less filing along the way in terms of getting your nails to be a certain shape. And so now we are up to the filing. I'm going to use the blue side because it has a much, I guess, more harsh grit, because I know that my nails will need that to be able to file down. So I'm going to go straight across in one direction. So I lift up every time and I just keep on going across till I get to my desired shape. And then I see where there's a corner after my nail has been filed. I see that there is kind of a sharp corner on one side, and I like to file that down on both sides. Okay, so my nails are done, and the direction that we are filing in is straight across. And you're just going to keep on doing this until you get to the square shape. You're going to go across as many times as you need, and then you're going to go in for the corners and just round the corners out on both sides in that direction that you were initially stroking it against. This is how it looks in the end on both hands, and that's how you shape your nails. I use this Calcium Boost base coat by Jordana. It's awesome. I use it every single tutorial without fail because it's just that great. It has left my nails looking so strong and healthy. My nails were splitting all the time across the top, and they were breaking. And once I used this and I got this, it just, I don't know, it's been miraculous for me. It's like $2. I know that they sell it on the website too for anybody who can't find it in stores. This is the final look. I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial for CristalLoverable. If you have any further questions as to how I got my nails to look this way, please let me know. And for anyone else who has any questions, feel free to comment and subscribe. And I guess I'll be seeing you guys soon. I'm going to be doing another nail tutorial for the new year right after this. So stay tuned. I'll see you guys soon. Bye.